Hi, I'm Taylor Jones.
And I'm Christopher Hall, and this is our poster presentation for the Linguistic Society of America Annual Meeting 2022, where a poster means a short talk.
Our object of study is a subset of negative sentences in AAE and other dialects that exhibits apparent NPI modification of a definite noun phrase. To get a feel for what we're talking about, here are a few examples.
Y'all don't know nothing about no Earth, Wind, and Fire. For anyone bad with band names, Earth, Wind, and Fire is the group that sang September and Boogie Wonderland.
Don't nobody care about no Taylor Swift.
I don't know nothing about no Drake.
I ain't giving a shit about no Drake.
These kids don't know nothing about no Gatorade in a glass bottle.
Lastly, if I were to say to Chris, I've read the introduction of Jesse Greaser's new book, The Black Side of the River, and now I know all about Southeast Washington, D.C., he could reply,
what you know about no black side of no river?
So our object of study is a subset of negative sentences that exhibits apparent NPI modification of a definite noun phrase, including proper nouns and other clearly definite NPs we'll discuss in a moment. We'll revisit these six examples shortly, but first a quick refresher on NPIs and definiteness.
Negative polarity items are items like any or ever that appear in negative sentences. They must be C-commanded by negation, and they are thought to be obligatorily indefinite. In some varieties, NPIs show negative agreement. So I ain't never seen no one like you is equivalent to I have not ever seen anyone like you.
Definiteness is generally discussed in terms of familiarity or identifiability and uniqueness or inclusivity. Here we're following lines. A simplification is that a definite NP is expected by the speaker to be uniquely identifiable to the hearer from shared discourse context and cultural assumptions. Examples include NPs marked by definite articles, possessives, some qualification, and proper nouns.
We've already seen no before proper nouns. It also is attested before items like any, every, and even no, and direct and indirect quotation.
So there are two possible analyses. The first is to posit that AAE has definite NPIs. The second is to situate no in pragmatics.
The definite NPI proposal has the benefit of accounting for the data, but it poses serious challenges for our understanding of negation and polarity, and it is unattested in other languages.
The pragmatics approach is to argue that no is truly indefinite, and that speakers choose to mark semantically definite items with an indefinite for emphasis or to challenge the assumptions of shared background knowledge and discourse context.
This works through downward entailment and through making the noun phrase now a topic and the speaker is negating something about the category or its attributes. This allows us to make sense of examples like, I don't care about no tonight, I'm talking about tomorrow.
And this example where it's clear from the context that the speaker is denying any knowledge of a very specific person. So revisiting our examples from before, I don't know nothing about no Drake, refuses to accept the interlocutor's assertion of the existence of such a person and any information about him.
Example two has the meaning that you aren't any good at spades. Example three is the same as number one.
Example four modifies a quote and means that one shouldn't make that specific statement or any similar statement. Examples 5 and 6 are similar, and both are in the linguistics literature on AAE. From the context, it's clear that the speaker in 5 is discussing his pigeon coop, but broadens his statement so that his coop is a downward entailment of the now more general statement.
Revisiting LeBove's example, Speedy is asked if a cat ever got into his coop. He says they never got into one of his. Junior suggests unless it's a jive coop, and Speedy counters with the now famous, it ain't no cat can't get in no coop. Junior's assumptions about the world can be represented like this.
And Speedy is challenging those assumptions. A jive coop isn't a coop at all, and I told you I built a coop. The meaning is still that no cat has ever gotten into his coop, but it's now an entailment of a broader statement rejecting the supposition of shared assumptions.
This context is important because these sentences become canonical in descriptions of African-American English and has downstream effects everywhere, from our classrooms to courtrooms, doctor's offices, and anywhere professional record-taking is involved.